one more fraction promise. But why not go into solving now and maybe we won't solve it at all? It's more difficult than what we did before. But anyway, I want to show it to you. We have a quarter letter and divide this size into equal parts. And then we join it this way. And then we have to find this area.
This is a 1/19.
19th?
Yes.
1/9.
Of course, 1/9. It's easy to guess the answer because since this answer is true, because since I asked this question, the answer must be the same for all quadrilaterals. But if you take a square, for example, then it is 1/9. So in fact, this is 1/9 problem. But to prove it, it's not easy. Okay. More difficult than what we had before.
Can we go for the square?
For the no.
For just
we cannot reduce any quadrilateral to a square. Нельзя свести задачу для произвольного четырехугольника квадрат. Если был параллелограмм, другой, но произвольный четырехугольник нет.
We can do this problem for parallelogram.
No, you can, but it is not enough. Because you cannot turn an arbitrary quadrilateral into a parallelogram. Нельзя превратить произвольный четырехугольник в параллелограмм using parallel projection, с помощью параллельной проекции. Так что по отношению к этому, maybe I will give you one more example of application of the methods. Еще одно применение массы последовательно. If we take this problem. So, how to get, for example, I want to find in what ratio do these segments divide one another. This can be easily done using methods.
1, 2, 3.
What methods to put at the vertices to have the center here? Какие массы поместить в точке вершины, а в среде, чтобы центр оказался здесь? And each of them is divided 1/2, which is